The village of Umbu in the Eastern Cape is known for its beautiful landscape and rolling hills. But it also has a history of a troubled past when a marauding beast from the depths of the valley, realizing the bounty that lied hidden in the scattered settlements, descended on one of the villages in search of human and animal prey. The people were at a loss as to what to do as it attacked the cattle, women and children, and seemed invincible. Despite this threat, the people were arguing over mundane issues.
Ha! Makosi! You must teach your children some manners. I asked them to help me fetch some wood from the bush, and they just clicked their tongues and shook their heads and walked away. Is that how you bring up your children?
Hey, Lambasadi. Tembi, where do you get off talking about my children? You have two sons that you can send, sons for that matter, that you can send to go and fetch wood for you. Instead, what do? You let them wander around in the community drinking alcohol, going around with girls, and yet you come here and tell me what to do with my children.
Your girls. You need to watch your girls. The way they flaunt themselves at the boys in the village. One of these days, one of them is going to lose her virginity and bring disgrace on the village.
Tembi, you have to take that image that you use to watch over my daughters and watch over your husband. Your husband is busy going around in the communities visiting ladies from house to house.
Now I have heard
you
enough.
Stop it,
ladies. You cannot be doing this. You are respected women in our society. You cannot be fighting about your children at this time. Don't you know that there's a beast which is killing people in our village? A beast which is killing our animals? When you keep on fighting like this, this will destroy our village. Stop it!
After Tembi heard all of this about her husband, she was embarrassed and withdrew from the other villages. Days pass and more cattle are carried away. The people are at a loss as to what to do and are starting to relinquish hope. They congregate in the village green to talk about their fears.
Lost already. This beast is bigger than all of us here. Really, there is no hope in our village. Nasiyambeni apha. Siye kwindawo ekhuselekileyo.
Yes. Ihlile wabulela ntate. The beast will kill all of us and our village will be destroyed.
Nyani ke, what will become of us, our families and our village?
Ndinqinela nawe kanti zizi. Namditsho, the only way to protect us is to move away from this village and go to a safer place. Ngohlobo busitsho ngalo.
Hayi mani nje ewe ntoni? Nihamba niyapi? We are a proud nation, a brave nation. We stood the test of time. Silapha kule ndawo. Namhlanje nifuna uhamba lula kanjalo. Singamagorha. Masililwe elihamncwa.
Hayi, asambe. Thank you, Tami, for reminding us of who we are as a nation. Masijongeni lento besithetha. Let us review that decision.
Yes.
Zizi nawe Tami ngenqilala nani. Makhe sishukumiseni man and revive our spirit and souls. Masiculele ingoma and beat drums.
Yes.
Ukwenzela basizazi ukuba na asoyiki thina soyisiza.
Kakade. Kakade.
Let us sing the praises of the universe in one voice.
Yes.
So that the fears in us can be destroyed.
Yeah.
Yes! Let us sing our songs of victory and so that our ancestors can lead us into victory.
Yes.
Ndinethemba latshona ilanga. Ndinethemba latshona ilanga. Ndinethemba latshona ilanga. Ndinethemba.
kunjena siziva senyuke ngethemba siziva sineminqili ba so happy because now we can see that there is unity and there's also a purpose for us to survive as a nation. We are not a weak nation. Our descendants, our forefathers are very strong. Our ancestors are very strong. No, ye can't only now. No, ye can't only now. Ni gamba kwala.
Wengo sa chobole sa pa.
In silence, we hear our inner voice carrying us to new heights, to confront our fears. In silence, we hear the ancestors commanding us to rise above ourselves so we can become new versions of ourselves. Out of our silence, we rise to take up arms against a sea of troubles. Out of our silence, we rise to confront our foe. And in our mind's eye, smell the sweet scent of victory. Amandla! Amandla! Amandla!
While the warriors tried to escape from their troubles by drinking and imagining how they would kill the beast, Khama, one of the brave warriors, did not participate in the merriment.
He transfixed his mind's eye on the destruction of the beast that was causing so much havoc in his beloved village and destroying the tranquility that was always a hallmark of his life here over all the years of his existence on earth.
A battle ensued, and after much toil, he managed to kill the beast and returned victorious.
The hunters, rousing from their sleep, looked forth, and lo, amidst the gold came one who toiled wearily, for neath a lion's skin he laboring strode. Hi.
Sisi, Fukani, wake up! I hear that something is coming! Something is coming!
Okay, people! Wake up, arise! Khama has killed the beast, Fukani!
Tis Khama! He had killed the mighty one! Tis Khama! Mighty chief!
And that, dear friends, is the story of how the beast was eventually killed and how peace was restored in the village. The beast is the metaphor of all the negativity in our lives and the fears that hold us down.
If you have a dream, grab your dream. Savor it, relish it, taste it, and let it permeate your entire being.
Arise above yourself to confront the problems and the fears that bog you down. Let a spirit of hopefulness permeate your being so that you become the master of your destiny.
Oh,